Welcome! If you're new around here and wondering why I'm painted, this is my Painted Anatomy series, in which I draw anatomical structures over my own skin. We're currently checking the upper limb, and since we last talked about upper limb arteries, today we're going to cover the upper limb drainage, the shoulder, arm, forearm, and hand veins. Greetings! Moving forward on our quest to review upper limb vascularization and innervation, we have once more our left upper limb placed in anatomical position here. Contrary to most arteries, veins can be seen, and we are going to use this to our advantage. We like to follow the structure's natural orientation, so we will draw our veins from distal to proximal, likewise the blood that's being drained. On our arteries video we drew the bones, but since veins are way more superficial than arteries, the bones are not as relevant to us today. And if you've watched the upper limb arteries video, you may be pleasantly surprised, or not, to hear this one will be much shorter, because since veins have a much greater variability, there is little point in discussing small veins unless we were to talk about how likely each anatomical variation is. But before we start with the hand, if you need an overlook just to orient yourself, keep in mind that all along through the entire length of the upper limb, there will be two major superficial veins, the basilic and the cephalic, and two major deep vein pairs, a pair of radial veins, and a pair of ulnar veins in the forearm that come together to form a pair of brachial ones in the arm. The superficial veins are often visible, and the deep ones roughly travel along the arteries and are almost always paired. And first, starting with the hand, let's zoom in on the hand for now, shall we? The veins in the hand are eventually going to drain to the forearm, so they must all coalesce into a handful of larger veins you probably already know. It all starts with the pairs of digital veins. Each finger has a pair of dorsal digital veins and a pair of palmar digital veins. The palmar digital veins mostly just drain to the dorsal digital veins through the intercapitular branches. The dorsal digital veins, on the other hand, or rather on the same hand, just on the other side, course laterally and medially down each finger before forming the dorsal metacarpal veins that drain to the dorsal venous network, a complex and variable network of veins on the posterior aspect of the hand. After multiple anastomoses, the network will then drain to both the cephalic and basilic veins. The cephalic vein is the more lateral one in the forearm, whereas the basilic is the more medial one. There is also a palmar venous network that drains into the median antebrachial vein, which may drain directly into the basilic vein. The cephalic and basilic vein, though, will course not only proximally, but also anteriorly, as they start posteriorly in the wrist, but are found anteriorly near the cubital fossa. Once in the forearm, they will communicate with the deep veins through the perforating veins and experience many small anastomoses, before facing a major anastomose between the both of them, the cephalic vein and the basilic vein. This may happen in the form of the median cubital vein, for example, or you may have a palmar venous network draining into a median antebrachial vein that then splits into a median cephalic vein towards the cephalic vein and a median basilic vein towards the basilic vein. If you think you can see which of these variations apply to my own arm here, maybe type it in the comments. By the way, there's probably an accessory cephalic vein here in my own arm. As I've said, veins are quite subject to anatomical variation. This sense should be more intuitive to us, because, contrary to most arteries, we can actually see the veins. And if you have ever had your blood drawn, you've probably seen one of these veins. How large each of these are will vary significantly from person to person, depending on the anatomical variation. There are also the higher pressure, deep antebrachial veins, presented in pairs, a couple radial veins and a couple ulnar veins, which will drain the muscles and structures from the deeper compartments of the forearm. There are also the anterior and posterior interossei veins. Once in the proximal forearm, they will all coalesce to form a pair of brachial veins, which will ascend close to the brachial artery, draining structures in the arm, such as the triceps and biceps brachii, before finally joining the basilic vein to form the axillary vein. This is the reason you can no longer see the basilic vein as clearly in the arm as you saw in the forearm. It pierces the fascia while going deeper to join the brachial one. The axillary vein will then still receive blood from the subscapular vein before draining the cephalic vein just below the scapula and thus becoming the subclavian vein. The cephalic vein, by the way, which started lateral in the arm and became anterior to pass in the deltopectoral groove between, you guess it, the deltoid and pectoralis major muscles and pierce the fascia there. Now, of course, we could go deeper. The veins we've talked about also have smaller tributaries of their own. The cephalic vein, for example, receives blood from the posterior and anterior circumflex veins, and the brachial vein receives blood from a pair of profunda brachii veins. But when in doubt about smaller veins, they usually run along arteries, just with greater anatomical variation. And so, this was our upper limb venous review. Thank you for watching all the way to that. This video topic was chosen on a poll I made on my YouTube community tab and on my Instagram page. So, if you want to suggest a future topic or vote on the next videos, you might want to go there. Bear in mind to take the poll results into account, even if there is but a single vote, so your vote might carry weight. And if you've liked this video, why not check my Painted Anatomy playlist, in which I explain anatomy by drawing over myself, and which includes my most successful video so far, my hand anatomy one. Or maybe you want to see something different, like OBGYN or cardiology. Your call. Thank you for choosing to share your time with me, and I hope to see you on the next video.